In this video, we are going to learn how to check for refrigerant leaks in an AC unit using nitrogen gas. Why is the nitrogen leak testing method used to check for leaks in an AC unit? When a refrigerant leak occurs in a unit, it is not always possible to identify the exact location of the leak using traditional methods. In such cases, the nitrogen leak testing method can be employed to pinpoint the source of the leak. But why nitrogen gas is used for leak detection in AC units? There are several reasons for using nitrogen gas. Nitrogen is an inert gas, meaning it is non-reactive. Since it is non-reactive, it does not react with any component in the AC equipment. Therefore, there is no risk of using nitrogen gas in an AC unit. And nitrogen is a dry gas, meaning it contains very low levels of moisture. This prevents corrosion from occurring in the equipment. Moreover, nitrogen is a non-toxic and non-flammable gas. Furthermore, nitrogen gas can withstand very high pressures. This makes it an excellent choice for leak testing. Finally, since nitrogen gas constitutes 78% of our atmosphere, it is readily available and inexpensive. For these reasons, nitrogen gas is widely used for leak testing. Now, let's look at the leak check procedure. The first step in the leak check procedure is to recover all the refrigerant from the leaking AC unit. We have uploaded a video on our channel explaining how to recover refrigerant. The link is provided in the description below for those who need it. Once the refrigerant has been recovered, we will gather the necessary equipment for the nitrogen leak test. This includes a nitrogen cylinder, a regulator, a manifold gauge. First, connect the regulator to the nitrogen cylinder. Always remove the regulator from the cylinder when you are finished using it. Leaving the regulator attached to the cylinder increases the risk of a nitrogen leak, as any accidental impact can damage the regulator, weakening its seals and connections. Nitrogen is stored in cylinders at very high pressure, and a leak can be dangerous. Therefore, always remove the regulator when you are finished using it. The regulator has two gauges. One gauge is used to measure the amount of nitrogen gas remaining in the cylinder. The other gauge is used to set the pressure that will be applied to the AC unit. After connecting the regulator to the cylinder, now connect the manifold gauge. If the outdoor unit has connecting ports on both the low pressure and high pressure lines, connect the blue hose to the low pressure line and the red hose to the high pressure line. However, if there is only a connecting port on the low pressure line, then connect only the blue hose to the low pressure line. After connecting the blue and red hoses, connect the yellow hose to the outlet of the regulator. Now, open the cylinder. When you open it, you can check the pressure in the cylinder using the first gauge. Then, adjust the handle in the middle of the regulator clockwise to set the pressure that will be applied to the AC unit. In this case, we will set the pressure to 250 psi. Now, slowly open the valves on the blue and red hoses of the manifold gauge. We have uploaded a video on our channel explaining how the manifold gauge works. The link to the video is provided in the description below for those who need it. Once the valve is open, it will take only a few seconds for the pressure in the AC units to reach 250 psi. Once the pressure gauge indicates 250 psi, close the valves on the red and blue hoses. Now, the AC unit is pressurized with nitrogen gas at 250 psi. Each AC unit has a maximum pressure capacity that must be observed during nitrogen leak testing. Exceeding this pressure can lead to damage to the unit's seals, gaskets, or other components, potentially causing new leaks or even equipment failure. Therefore, it's crucial to determine the appropriate pressure for nitrogen charging and adhere to that limit. Now, use soap bubbles to check for leaks at all joints. If there is a leak, when you apply soap bubbles to the area where the leak is suspected, many bubbles will form in that spot. This confirms the presence of a leak. An AC unit with no leaks should be held in pressure for at least 30 minutes. During this hold period, if there are any leaks in the unit, the pressure will drop due to nitrogen leakage. A decrease in pressure indicates a leak in the unit. The longer the hold time, the more accurate the results will be. If the exact location of a leak cannot be determined, a portion of the refrigerant should be left in the unit after recovery, and then nitrogen should be charged. When this is done, if there is a leak in the unit, some refrigerant will leak, along with the nitrogen. Now, using an electronic leak detector, the exact location of the leak can be accurately determined. By applying soap bubbles to that area, we can see where the leak is coming from. We will discuss it in the next video, how to repair it using brazing method if a leak is detected. If there are no leaks, close the nitrogen cylinder and turn the handle on the regulator fully counterclockwise to reduce the pressure. Then, remove the yellow hose from the regulator and slowly open the valve on low pressure line to release all the nitrogen gas. Next, vacuum the unit, recharge it with refrigerant, and run it. This is a detailed method of leak detection using nitrogen gas. If you have any doubts about this video, please ask in the comments section. If you find this video helpful, please share it with others. Don't forget to subscribe to our Zebra Learnings channel. Thank you.